Yeah.
Okay, great, great. Okay. So, good morning, everyone. I'm your host for the day. Myself, Rupesh. I'm working with Synergetics as a digital strategist. Let's begin with our today's session that is on DA100 certification, analyzing data with Microsoft Power BI. So before moving ahead with the session, I would like to give a small introduction about Synergetics. So Synergetics is an innovative company who is majorly working into B2B segment as well as B2C segment. So our key strengths are reskilling and onboarding solutions. Those are based on today's cutting edge technologies. So our prime focus areas are persona-based onboarding, reskilling solution, certification solution, emerging technology training, cloud adoption solution, practice development. So our today's session is organized by ATC community, that is Azure Tech community, and sponsored by Synergetics and Microsoft. So professionals who are interested in Microsoft cloud technologies as well as the various trendy technologies and high demanding technologies like big data analytics, IoT, cloud, DevOps, they can follow our communities which are already there. So it's very simple. All of you just have to install an application called Meetup. Okay, once you download the application in your phone, you just have to search for this communities, emerging technology community, that is ETC community, then Azure Tech community Pune for the Pune people, Surat and Gujarat emerging technology community for people who belongs to Gujarat, Azure Tech community Nagpur for the people from Nagpur, and artificial intelligence AI on Microsoft platform, so people who are interested in artificial intelligence technology. So once you'll follow this Meetup community, so you will be notified with the latest announcements from our side, that is a webinar, Meetup, event that is going to happen, so you'll get a timely notifications through this. So I'll request everyone to just download the application and follow our Meetup communities. Thank you so much. So the next is a code of conduct. So please note everyone that you cannot take the screenshot of the record of the session, and you cannot record this session. So if you want the recording, you can just follow our YouTube channel. The link will be shared in the chat box. Please do follow that once it will be shared. So our today's session is on DA100, that is analyzing data with Microsoft Power BI. And our agenda for today's session is analyzing data with Microsoft Power BI, DA300, DA100 skills measured and widgets, prerequisites and objectives, how to book and to take the exam online, ingest, clean and transform data, model data for performance and scalability, design and create reports for data analysis, apply and perform advanced report analytics, manage and share reportesses, create efficient reports in Power BI. One important notification I want to share with you. The session were given to Ms. Chitra Iyer, and due to some medical emergency, this session is handover to Mr. Chandrasekhar, sir. I'll give you a small introduction about him. Chandrasekhar, sir, is working in this tech corporate industry for more than 30 years. His core experience is in data-related technologies. He's Microsoft certified trainer. He worked with many Fortune companies like Accenture, Infosys, Intel, and many more, and delivered great knowledge sessions on today's highly demanded technologies like big data analytics, machine learning, Azure DevOps, Azure and Hadoop. So this is our training calendar for the month. Anyone who's interested in any of these trainings, they can get back to me. The contact number will be shared in the chat box. So currently we are offering 50% flat off on all the trainings, and here we are providing your training plus MOC plus exam vouchers. So you will be getting the whole package. So do contact me if you are interested. As you all know, that currently we are conducting two different kind of sessions. One is CERT Ready and other is ETT. So our next CERT certification webinar is based on PL100 Introduction to Power Virtual Agent. That is happening on 24th July. Session time will be 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. Anyone who's interested, they can enroll, they can register themselves. Again, the registration link will be shared in the chat box. This is our webinar calendar for the year. I know it is too much, but yeah, one by one we'll be announcing through the session. So the next web emerging technology webinar will be on DevOps. That is DevOps with Azure DevSecOps with Azure DevOps, and the session will be happening on 10th July, 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. 2 hour session. Okay, so you can register yourself. The link will be shared in the chat box. One special announcement. As many of you know that in every session we are try to give something special to you guys. So again, in this session also we are giving five lucky winners. We are giving the Microsoft sponsored exam vouchers. So these winners will be selected from the feedback that will be submitted from you. So we'll be sharing the feedback form link during this session as well as at the end of the session. So before leaving the session, please do check that link, fill up the form, and through that we'll be selecting five lucky winners who can get the five exam vouchers. One more special note I want to make here, that if you have we have a restriction over the time, so the session will be for 2 hours. So if the last 15 minutes will be for question and answer session, Q&A session. So there will be, if there will be more questions. So yeah, there's another way where you can put your questions in the form. Okay. So anyone who's having questions, they can put their questions in the comment section that is available in the feedback form, and the answers will be given to them appropriately. Okay. So thank you so much, guys. That's it from my end. Now I'll hand over mic to Chandrasekhar sir. So you may continue from here.
Good morning all, Chandrasekhar here. I am sharing my screen, so would like to know whether screen is reaching to you. Let me know, is it
yes.
Reaching to
you? Yes.
It's visible and you're audible. Thank you.
Yeah,
it's visible. Thank you.
Thanks. Okay, I believe many of you are from either a developer's background or from database background, or even some of you may be from testing background. This session, I believe, will be helpful to everybody. Here we will begin with what exactly data analytics is, and how we can use a Power BI to play its role in analyzing the data and creating different kinds of reports. So we will also see different architectures where this Power BI can be used for the purpose of visualization. We will also go through a demo where I will show you how can we work with the data on premise, I mean to say by using desktop tool, and then how can we publish it on Power BI service. So these things also we could see, and we will also try to understand whenever you want to go for certification, how you will go for it and what type of cares you will take while going for the certifications. Data analytics is science or discipline that encompasses complete management of data. As on today, what is happening is that company has got lots of data, but they want to present the data. They want to analyze the data to extract a meaning out of it and use that meaning for the business purpose. In the business, there is a cutthroat competition, and there we realize that the company who is effectively using data analytics in their day-to-day life, always has upper edge over the company who still is using old traditional systems. So I don't have to put much words in it because all of you are aware of the importance of the data analytics. So here in data analytics, we take a raw data and we uncover different patterns from the data. We may get data from variety of the data sources as on today. So in case if it is the business data, we may get it from database. In case if it is the what we will say schema-less data, we may get it in terms of images, audios, videos. In case if it is the same schema data, I mean to say no SQL data, we may get it in the form of XML, CSV file, JSON file. So we have different types of data as on today, and we have different sources of data. So we may get data from that. Hello? Please keep yourself on mute. We may get data from variety of the sources. Earlier, we used to have the data only from the database or into the database, but as on today, we get data from the say logs of the servers, from clicks on the websites, from data collected from IoT devices, data and image frames collected from CCTV footage. So we have different types of data. We have different sources of data. Okay, and keeping that thing in mind, we have to push that data to undergo into multiple steps to be carried out before data analytics. So we may have to clean the data, transform the data, convert the data to make it suitable for the analytics purpose, and finally then we may analyze the data. After doing analysis of the data, we may visualize data by drawing or by putting that data into different visuals. Management do not like to see data in the tabular form. They want to see data into different visuals. So maybe pie chart, maybe bar chart, maybe scatter chart. So here, Power BI basically is a tool for two purposes. One is to push the data to undergo into cleaning, munging, transformation phase, and then finally create the dashboard of different visuals from the data. So doing analytics on the data is one thing, and visualizing the analytics of the data is the another thing, and both these things are possible in Power BI. Analytics gives the business access to insight. Yes, to get better insight of the business, analytics is necessary. Being a data analyst, your prerequisite, first and very important prerequisite, is your wish and will. In case if you want to change a persona from event tester, not to worry about. Even testers also can change their persona easily in data analytics. And the reason is, now as on today for data analytics, we have lots of graphics, GUI based tools, drag and drop, so which makes job of a person really simple. So even if you are from developer's background, you are from Oracle, I mean to say database background, or from tester background, not to worry about data. You can change your persona to data analyst. Enable business to maximize the value of their data assets using Microsoft Power BI. In case if you are from .NET background, you might have worked with SSRS, reporting service, SQL Server reporting service. So Power BI is next modified version of SSRS. Okay, we can go with a Power BI for drawing different visuals. Responsible for designing and building scalable models, cleaning and transforming data. Sometimes somebody may ask me the question like, in case if there are say visualization arrangement in Excel, why should we go with a Power BI? So answer to that is Power BI can handle much larger volumes of data compared to Excel. In Excel, there are limits to deal with the size of the data, but in Power BI, it is basically for huge data volumes. So there you will see upper hand of Power BI. Also, Power BI inherit many features from Excel, Power Apps, Okay, and that's why in case if you are from that background, then you will see comparable. You will see yourself in comparable zone while working with Power BI. Collaborate with the key stakeholders. Have a fundamental understanding of data repositories and data processing. So all these are the different roles for data analyst. But data analyst basically is to deal with, working on the data. So cleaning of the data, transformation of the data, analyzing the data and presenting the data. These are main four responsibilities on data analyst. As on today, this analysis of the data is being used in each and every field. I don't see even a single science field, where we don't see any role for a data analyst. Everywhere, in every science field, as on today, we can see a role of data analyst. As on today, very fast growing field is a social network. Social network. So Twitter, WhatsApp, Facebook, all they are generating text data, image data, and variety of the data. And by analyzing this data, it is very essential to analyze the sentiments of the customers. And that is what a very hot topic as on today. Okay, here every day we hear the news like WhatsApp decided to sell the data to the company. Facebook decided to sell the data to some enterprise. So why enterprise is interested in the chats we did in WhatsApp or the chats we did in Facebook? They want to understand our sentiments. And they obviously that they want to, draw some meaning out of the sentiments of the customers and to align their businesses, their business, to make it pro customer. So that is one of the hot topic as on today. Here you observe this architecture. This architecture will bring one aspect of using Power BI in complete canvas of web of enterprise application. So here you can see Power BI has a role to play here to draw different visuals. Now here Power BI is getting data ready data, analyzed, ready analyzed data it is getting. So here we are not harnessing data cleaning and data analysis power of Power BI, but we are harnessing power of Power BI to present visuals. Analyzed data it is receiving from analyzed services. Actual analysis is happening in a SQL data warehouse. The SQL data warehouse to have an engine to actually analyze the data. And analysis services is creating, model of the data, and it also caches the data. So whenever Power BI executes any query, that query first of all go to analysis services. If analysis services has a kind of snapshot of presentation, I mean to say snapshot of the data against that query, immediately that snapshot will reach to the Power BI and Power BI will draw different visuals on that. In case if analysis service does not have a snapshot of that data, maybe analysis service will have to procure the data from SQL database, create the snapshot against that query and submit that snapshot to the Power BI. The point what I am trying to bring to your notice is here we are harnessing only visualization power of Power BI. Okay, actual analysis is happening into SQL data warehouse. There are two types of data coming in. Real-time data. This real-time data is the data generated maybe by IoT devices or logs of the server. Real-time data also can be submitted to Power BI. Here I haven't shown it, but yes, Power BI does have, connectors which can ingest the data, coming from real-time data sources, So real-time data also can be visualized. The static data also can be visualized. This is the static data pipeline where we are doing a rigorous analysis on huge quantity of the data and those aggregations and those results we are presenting in terms of visuals. Here in Power BI, we can create a dashboard. On that dashboard, a variety of the visuals can be shown, and visuals can be shown in terms of pie chart, we can in terms of bar chart. Okay, so different types of visuals we can show here. So here I can see a role for Power BI. What exactly Power BI is? What are all different features of the Power BI? Just a minute. So Power BI is a collection of services, apps, connectors to turn unrelated. Just a minute. I think I added a couple of slides here. Okay, those are ahead. No problem. So we can connect to different data sources, and for establishing the connection, we do have a set of connectors in Power BI. I will show you the list of the connectors Power BI can use to connect to a variety of the data sources. It's very long list, and there you will realize through the Power BI, we can connect to each and every type of data source on the cloud as well as on the premises. We can visualize the data. We can discover the patterns in that data. For this purpose, we may have to do a kind of analytics, so that also we can do here. Okay, and whenever we draw different visuals, we create a dashboard. That dashboard we can share with the team members. So we can decide the privileges, who can, who will be able to what kind of dashboard. Okay, so we can decide also. Another important thing is we can create a dashboard for mobile applications also. So on my mobile, I simply have to install one agent. Through that agent, I will connect to the Power BI service, and whatever be the dashboard we create and enable to see it in the mobile, we can see it on the mobile also. So it is end-to-end solution. Actually, it is end-to-end solution for analytics purpose. We can have live dashboard having multiple visuals over there. We can create a reports. Data set is actually representing actual data. So this data is a raw data. It can be, you know, cleaned data. It can be transformed data also. We can, you know, work with the data in the real time. So there may be, where is the cursor? There may be data coming from the data sources, and in real time, we can populate that data into the data set, and we can see the graphs and visuals changing with a change in the data dynamically. Okay, so natural language query is also there. Sharing and collaboration among team members is also there. So all these things are available there in the Power BI. These are the steps we follow while working with the Power BI. So we prepare the data, we explore the data, we mine the data, we extract the data. Okay, and then we create the reports from the data. Here in this phase, we may apply different kinds of transformations using Power BI only, and thereafter we can share the data. So all these things we can do in Power BI. So in the earlier diagram of architecture, I might have shown you to use the Power BI only for the visualization purpose, but that is not the only feature of the Power BI. We can, you know, make all these things possible on the data through Power BI. And besides that, Power BI has a REST API also. So by doing a REST calls in your application, by doing the REST calls, you can ingest different dashboards in your application. So you may have Java application or Python application, and there, you know, you can get the dashboard in your application, and you can populate that dashboard or components of dashboard well on the web pages of your application. This is a kind of a dashboard. So different facts and figures you can show, different types of tiles you can show. Every tile will come up with very useful, valuable information about the data. So we will try to create a kind of a dashboard soon. Uses of Power BI. Connect to data to ingest from the data source. Transform and clean that data to create a data model. This step also we will try to do. Create different kinds of visuals such as charts or graphs that provide visual representation of the data. So we will try to create some of the charts and graphs. Create reports that are collection of visuals. So we can create tabular reports also. We can one or more report pages. So we can navigate these different pages of the report through the pagination feature. And to whoever we want to share the reports, that also we can do. And we can share the reports on mobile. We can share the reports on web applications. We can share the reports to the team members who are using Power BI. So that's all what we can do using Power BI. Different Power BI components. So these are two main components, desktop and service. Desktop is a thing or a Power BI component to be installed on your local machine. So on your local machine, you can work with the data and you can make data ready for presenting it on the dashboard. But for performing cleaning of the data, for performing transformation of the data, and for creating different visuals, we can use desktop. We will not use desktop to create a dashboard, but we will use desktop to do every prerequisite on the data before we create a dashboard. So desktop-based authoring tool of choice for connecting, transforming, and modeling the data for creating interactive reports. So we can create interactive reports, and then we may use these interactive reports to create a dashboard. We can create a dashboard in Power BI service. Power BI service is web-based service for collaboration, sharing. It is web-based service. Okay, and we can design dashboard here in web-based service. So we can create a dashboard here. Additional functionalities such as Q&A and alerts also can be generated through Power BI service. Somebody may refer it to as a Power BI site. Somebody may refer it to as a Power BI com. We will refer to it as a Power BI web portal. Once we create our reports, okay, we can publish those reports as a mobile app, and that dashboard what we design, we can publish it for mobile app, and that dashboard can be seen by all those who are using mobile. Okay, logistics, such mobile apps become very important. Okay, and very useful. Native applications on Android, Windows, for viewing reports and dashboards from anywhere. On-premise gateway, an agent installed in the corporate network. On-premise installation of the agent, that is called as an on-premise gateway. Through the on-premise gateway, we can connect to, accumulate the data, and we can get that data into dashboards. And using Power BI service or using Power BI mobile apps, on-premise data also can be visualized. For that purpose, we have to have an agent installed on-premise. Power BI reporting service, report server, a dedicated server to generate reports. Okay, variety of reports, so that is also possible. Power BI embedded API for embedding visuals into custom applications. So you may have your Java application or Python application. Okay, and inside that application, along with other data, you may want to show some visuals. So you can use Power BI embedded for that purpose, and you can show your visuals there. So that is about Power BI. Embedded, which can embed the reports into your web application, custom web application. Power BI app, the container in Power BI service for reports, dashboard, and data sets. They are read-only for user. So So Power BI app is available through which we can connect to variety of the SaaS applications also, and we can ingest the data from them, and that data also can be shown on dashboard. Power BI live connection, natural language querying. So lots of components are there for Power BI, and thereby Power BI offers you end-to-end solution on data analysis and visualization. Different scenarios where you can effectively use a Power BI. So here you see there is a data source, and this data source is on the cloud, and this data source is on premise. Okay, we can, you know, ingest the data from both types of data sources into Power BI desktop. So Power BI desktop, I already told you, it's a tool installable on the local machine. Okay, I also have installed it in my machine. I will show you. Okay, and there we can, you know, ingest the data. We can query the data, we can create the data sets, and we can create a different reports of the data. So that is Power BI data desktop. Okay, and once we clean the data, transform the data, do different operations on the data, and make it, you know, suitable for presentation, okay, then we can create a reports also, and then we will publish that data for Power BI service. Power BI service, I already told you, it is actually on cloud. I mean to say, it is a separate cloud-based service, browser-based service. We can visit through the browser, and there also we can do different operations on the reports, and we can create a dashboard. Here also analyze, we can analyze it into the Excel. Okay, so here you observe, in case if on the browser, we want to ingest the data from on-premise, that is also possible. Okay, different data reports can be generated, and finally we can publish the data. So this is for self-service and ad hoc analysis, where developer, Power BI developer, okay, or data analyst will be creating all these reports for the purpose of the designing. It is basically for the purpose of the designing. Organizational reporting. Now team is designing the things. It is not a one person, but a team is designing the things. So data gets ingested from analysis services. Okay, in the architecture that I have shown to you earlier, we already have seen analysis services there. Okay, into Power BI desktop. Okay, and from Power BI desktop, we may create a cleansing and other operations. Okay, and then, so there may be two types of data being generated. One is historical data or a static data, and another is a dynamic data that has been generated in the real time. And by using both these data, we may have to draw different visuals. So there we may use Power BI service to draw different dashboards. Okay, and these dashboards can be, or these visuals can be seen in mobile application, or it can be seen in web applications of Java, Python, or any other platform. This is for organizational reporting. Can work like any other reporting tool in which it issues live queries to retrieve source data when a report is viewed. So different queries also can be submitted. Live queries also can be submitted from here. Natural language processing is the feature they are adding. So even if you are not comfortable with a querying, okay, through the natural language processing, you can intimate to it what kind of report do you want. Okay, and it will understand your pronunciation. It will understand your natural language, whatever you type there, your words, not pronunciation, sorry, your words, and accordingly, it will understand which table to access, what are all columns it has to access, or exactly which kind of report it has to access. Okay, so even if you don't know SQL properly, okay, still, excuse me, it can ingest the data. Operational reporting and embedded analytics, wherein your reports go on the custom applications. There also, you know, your data can be queried, ingested from different sources, from on-premise also, okay, through the on-premise gateway. Here in the service, we may work, we may create a dashboard, okay, and that dashboard can be, you know, pulled into custom application. Okay, different tiles can be pulled, different reports can be pulled, or whole dashboard we can pull there, and we can show that dashboard in our applications. That is called as the embedded analytics. Near real-time reporting. Near real-time reporting means whenever data is generated, immediately it is consumed for designing, for populating different visuals. So here is the data ingested into stream analytics. Now, what is the role of Event Hub? That I will let you know. Ingested into stream analytics, actual analytics will happen here. Okay, and analyzed data we may push to database for preservation, or that data can directly even go into Power BI service also and is immediately populated into different visuals. Now here, Azure Stream Analytics can analyze the data. Here we have to declare predefined process for analyzing the data. Sometimes it may happen that there are lots of steps being followed in analyzing the data, and that's why speed of the consumption of the data is little low. Here, speed of the consumption of the data is little low, okay, compared to the speed with which data is getting generated. So here, the velocity with which data is coming in is high, but velocity with which data is going out is low, it is slow. And that's why we need somebody else, you know, to preserve the data, to ensure not even a single part of the data, single bit of the data be lost. And that is the role for Event Hub. Event Hub preserves each and every bit that it receives, and, you know, supplies it to the stream analytics when stream analytics need it. Okay, so there is an ingestion of the data, there is a preservation of the data. On Azure platform, Event Hub, IoT Hub, like services are there. From the open source, Apache Kafka like services are available, and Kafka is also available on Azure. So the purpose of all these three services, Kafka, Event Hub, IoT Hub, basically is to preserve the data to match the speed of incoming data with the consumption of the data. So it offers a kind of a buffer, because at one side data comes in with very high speed, and at another side data goes out with maybe little slow speed. So here we have to have a kind of a storage buffer. So that is the role for Azure Event Hub, IoT Hub, or Kafka. Data is preserved in database also. Analyzed data is preserved in database also, and that data we can use to draw different visuals on the Power BI. Different licensing operation. Power BI, a free version is available. It is for limited duration. Power BI Pro, it is paid, and Power BI Free can be upgraded to Power BI Pro, or you can directly purchase Power BI Pro. Okay, all enterprise level features you get in Power BI Pro. There is something called as the Power BI Premium also. Okay, it offers few more add-ons to Power BI Pro. Hello, anybody has any question? Somebody wants to ask question, please go ahead. Hello. Okay. Sorry.
We don't have the option for the dashboard even.
Where?
In the Power BI desktop.
No, Power BI desktop basically is a tool to manage the data before we publish it on the dashboard. So desktop allows you all munging type of solutions and creating different visuals, but not the dashboard. Dashboard we have to create in Power BI service.
Okay, sure. Thank
you. That Power BI, it is a free. So how many days it is a free, a Power BI?
Actually, see, it is changing. What I remember is it is for 1 month, but I used it for 6 months also. But now I recently came to know that again, its duration has been changed. So you have to just check with say new guidelines for how many days it is available as of me.
Okay. For Power BI, we need to learn SQL also, SQL database.
No, no. In case if you learn SQL database, it is good, but it is not mandatory. Means without writing even a single query, I will show you how can we work with the data. So I will show you how can we work with the data without writing even a single query. So even if you are aware of basic SQL, it will work in all normal scenarios. Even if you don't know SQL, you can deal with many scenarios.
So, sir, can we say that the Power BI is one combined tool which can be used as creation of the database, then keeping it for the purpose of reporting, putting it on the, let's say, internet also, for example, on cloud for the dashboard purpose. So prior we were using, let's say, one database and then one intermediary tool to push it on net and then an ASP page to project the data. Here, one complete tool set is there, which help you to create, run a query, visualize the database, and that to create a dashboard on live dashboard, right? Is it like that?
Yes, yes, except one thing. Everything is fine except the first point what you mentioned is whether we can use it to create a database. No, okay. We can ingest the data from the database. We can ingest the data not only from database, but variety of the data sources. We create a data set here. We cannot call data set as a database. Data set is a snapshot of data meant to see the different visuals.
Okay, so that means we need to create, every data should be there either on Excel, XS, SQL or whatever as a backend. Power BI would have some connector or add-in which will pick the data from these particular backend services.
Yeah.
And then project it further.
Yes, correct. So, absolutely.
So, sir,
extra component added, or it would be, automatically coming along when we are installing Power BI?
No, no, you come up with a question again. I could not hear it completely.
Sir, is it like if I install Power BI on my laptop, will it be able to incorporate all the data automatically once I provide the path, of course? Or do I need to have some extra components or add-ins?
No, no, no. I will show you. We don't need extra components. There are additional connectors we can install, but otherwise all normal connectors are available there. Or all general connectors are available there. And the count of those general connectors is also very long, very big.
Okay.
So you don't have to install any component for that purpose, specifically while ingesting data from all general data sources.
Okay, I mean, inbuilt feature is there that it can understand these existing databases structure.
Yes, yes, yes.
One last and very stupid question. If we have such a powerful tool like Power BI, why are we having so much resources coming into like one team for reporting, one for projection of the data on dashboard? I mean, kind of stuff.
No, no, I did not get this question.
So if it is such a powerful tool, Power BI, why industry, IT industry, is not using it on a very large scale?
Okay.
I mean, we are still into one ASP page designed, connected to some database, lot of intermediaries activities going on.
See, there are two points of justifications. Well, first is, many companies do have a choice of the vendor. This Power BI is a Microsoft tool. Okay, so who all are, you know, showing a trust on Microsoft tool, they definitely will go with a Power BI and they will not choose any other tool. That is one thing. Second important thing is you asked about why do we design you know, this visual generation in the web application. Yes, I may want to design my custom application and where I want to show different charts. Those charts we can design using Power BI, and those charts we will pull into our web application, and we will present those charts through web application instead of, you know, showing those charts to your client through the dashboard. I am designing one web application and I want to show the charts to my customer base. Okay, through my web application. So there I have to use my web application and, you know, pull in the charts into web application while showing my custom dashboard to the client.
Yeah. The custom. I just have one question. So besides Power BI showing up the charts, you know, to make the leaders take some decision support, does it also give suggestions, you know, based on previous feeds in terms of if it is like this, then this kind of decision can be taken, something like that?
You mean recommendations?
Correct, exactly. More intelligent recommendations. Can Power BI is capable of doing?
Yes, they are introducing that feature, and with every new version, we do see improvement in that area.
Okay.
Sir, there's one question. What is the difference between Power BI Free and Power BI Desktop? Basic difference.
See, Power BI Free, in Power BI Free, you get desktop and BI service both. Include the ability to use, but basic feature only. You don't get advanced features. Power BI Free basically is for single user who wants to do small processing and who just want to see how good this tool is. But so Power BI Desktop is a part of Power BI Free. I also had Power BI Desktop as a free version. I also had it earlier. So when you buy Power BI Free, you get Power BI Desktop installed as well as Power BI service. Both you get for limited period.
Okay, sir. But in both these licenses, you can use any data source and you can cleanse it or you can change it in both this type of these licenses, like Power BI Free and Power BI Desktop, right?
So Power BI Desktop is not a separate license. Power BI Desktop is a part of is a tool which is a part of which comes with the Power BI Free. It comes with Power BI Pro. It also comes with Power BI Premium. It is a tool. Power BI Desktop is not a license. It is a tool.
Okay. But
we can do all the types of operations, cleansing operations.
That is my all cleansing type of operations and even the dashboard also, the way we want. At least the maximum features we can use.
Yes. Not all features are available, but yes, features are available for designing simple dashboard.
And premium might be premium and pro might be used for the projection, right? They can project to their colleagues, their organization, and all that.
Collaborate with the colleagues in Power BI service, so we can assign privileges to the team members. Publishing of the data and privileges of access. Whether somebody can see the report, whether somebody should be denied to see the report, whether somebody can modify the report, whether somebody is denied to modify the report, those privileges we can assign.
For both premium and pro, right sir?
Yes. Okay. If we want to lock the columns, if we want to lock the rows, if we want to lock the visuals, all these things are possible in pro and premium.
Okay, thank you, sir. Understood.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir. This is regarding the publishing and embedding the reports. So when we are embedding reports in application, do we have to create some Azure service and refer that like key and something?
No. No Azure service as such. We can create the embedded reports where, you know, it will create a script for me that script, then I have to copy paste and put into my web application. Inside that script, token and all those things are put. Okay, so when that script is put into the web application, you know, web application first of all will use token to identify itself and then will get that report.
Okay, so but this, yeah, but these reports will be hosted on web, right? Actually, cloud. So Power BI internally uses Azure for hosting.
No, Power BI itself is a cloud service. It doesn't have to be hosted on Azure. Azure is separate thing. Power BI is a kind of a cloud service. The reports which are being shown in your web application, those are shown to you through REST APIs. And that REST API request hits to the Power BI cloud. It hits to your Power BI cloud.
Okay.
There is no role of Azure here while working with it.
Okay. Any service tier that we have to go when we are using, say, hundreds of reports or we are catering to thousands of end users who are simultaneously, hitting that report. So do we have to consider some kind of tier which will take care of thousands of hits?
No, here see Power BI Premium offers you different data limits and different request limits also. So in Power BI Premium, more users are being connected. It is a pay as you go. You will incur more billing. Huh? So depending on the number of requests hitting the Power BI cloud, you will be billed.
Okay, thank you.
Yes.
Yeah, hello.
Yes.
Yeah, what about the cost for Power BI Premium and Power BI Pro?
That is a separate point to discuss. I think you will get the cost model if you do a quick search on the net. Or if you want me to share some URLs, I will share it separately.
Okay.
Well, there are many models actually, depending on your use. You can choose one of the models.
Okay.
Yes.
Sir, okay, do we need to, instances, even if we, for Power BI Premium and Pro, if we plan to integrate the Power BI in our Power Platform application, still end users who just read the report, will they need to have licenses explicitly for that?
No, see, in case if you are generating reports through Power BI free, those reports are accessible within your Power Apps also. It doesn't need a kind of a pro or premium type of licensing. But for advanced features, for dynamic report generations, for interactive report generations, then those reports are to be are possible through premium or pro license. But in order to access the reports well within Power Apps, you don't need a licensing, or at least I am not aware of it.
Thank you, sir.
So what is the difference between SSRS and Power BI? And what is the modified version of Power BI?
Modified version of Power BI is Power BI itself. They are introducing newer version of Power BI. That is one thing. And second thing is SSRS is on-premise report generation. In case if you want to have SSRS service on cloud, exactly SSRS service on cloud, there is no equivalent of SSRS on cloud. You will have to, install SSRS on the virtual machine. But for the report generation and for the visualization, you have modified and equivalent, not exactly equivalent, but you have modified service in terms of Power BI. We will do one thing now. I will start a Power BI. Hello?
Whether Power BI is available on-premise fully, maybe because of banking restrictions, regulations, can we use it as an on-premise application?
You mean Power BI desktop?
Power BI desktop or even services can be installed on-premise because of banking regulation, data cannot go to cloud.
Yes, but I cannot comment much on that. For all types of Azure services and cloud services, they are offering you on-premise equivalent. They are offering you. So I believe Power BI, for Power BI also, there is something equivalent. For all types of services now, they are offering you on-premise equivalents because of these compliances and security issues. Okay.
So that Power BI support server is on-prem equivalent of Power BI service on the cloud, right? Or is there a difference between Power BI report server versus Power BI on cloud?
Power BI report service is available on the cloud, sorry, on premises. No? Power BI report server is available on premises. Thanks.
Quick check. Can we ask park the questions in the last?
Yes. Requesting to everybody, we will hold on for the questions now, and then we will arrange a special session of 15 minutes, Q&A session for 15 minutes at last. Fine. What I do here, I start the Power BI desktop. And here I will get the data. Okay, fine, I'm closing this. I will get the data from some file, and here you can see from what are all different data sources we can get the data. Power BI data sets, SQL servers, analysis services. This is SSRS. We can get data from there also. More. I have AccessDB data with me. Okay, so I just want to ingest the data from AccessDB, and here you simply have a look at the set of connectors, where wide variety of connectors available. So we can ingest data from SAP applications, Amazon Redshift, Teradata, different databases here, IBM services, okay, and different Azure services. So here is a list of Azure services from where we can ingest the data, different SaaS applications, Dynamics 365, different SaaS applications, okay, Salesforce reports. So it's a very long list from where we can ingest the data. Out of this list, I am choosing for Access Database. I have a data in terms of Access file. I'm connecting to the Access Database. Okay, and here it is asking me for the file wherever it is. Okay, so I have a file here. This file I am choosing, clicking on open. And here it has got the list of the tables into that database. So I have an Access file which I am importing here, and their data has been segregated across these multiple tables. So I have got data into Power BI, and here it is showing me list of the tables. If I select one of the tables, I can see what are all different columns and what are all different rows there. This is geographical data. This is a data about the manufacturers. I want all the data, all the tables I want to import except the last one. Okay, I'm deliberately ignoring the last one to show to you that it is not mandatory for me to choose everything from the list of the tables. And here then I can click on load, or I can click on transform data. I am clicking on load at the beginning to go with. And when I click on load, see, it is now loading whole data into Power BI desktop.
Okay.
No, data size is huge. That's why it, we have to give it some time to load the complete data. So let it load the data, but it is showing me the progress, how many rows it is loading from different tables. And here it is showing me the names. Now, if I click on any of the table, name of the table, I can see from here. If I click here, okay, it can show me the details of the table. Okay, now for this table, say date table. Okay, if I want to do modifications, apply kind of transformations, I can click here on edit query. And here you can see I can do different transformations in this window. Now to the table it is calling as a query, because internally it is executing select star from table name like query. If I want to change the names of the table, so for example, I want to change the name to this table as a date. I can change its name. So first of all, let me give appropriate names to it. This is for location, so I will change it to location. This is manufacturer. I change it to manufacturer. This is a product. Sales table. So I will change it to sales. Fine. So I have changed the names of these tables. Okay. I may do some changes into the column level changes into the table. Say, for example, this is sales table. Okay, and in this table, these are the columns. So column names it is showing to me. As of now, you will realize this date. Okay, column is a text column. If I want to see the type of the column, and if I want to change the type of the column, from here I can change the type. I can remove the column, I can duplicate the column. Okay, I can apply different transformations on the column, can split the column, group the column. Lots of operations are available here out of these. Okay, let me just change the type of the column to date. As of now, its type is a text. I want to change it to date. So I'm clicking on date. And see, it has been changed to date. Similarly, if I want to apply the filter on the date, so a filter I will show you. Let me just apply some changes on the column first. So here I have applied on cells. Okay, let me just change the type in the date also. This date column, again it is text, so I want to change it again to date type, and that is done. If I want to apply filtering, okay, I just do not want all the records. Just a minute. I just want to have sets of records only, so that is also possible. For example, here if I want to apply filtering, date filter after, and if I want to apply filter after 31st December 1999, so basic filter, I do not want to apply any complex filter. I simply want to apply basic filter, and from here I can check for the date. So maybe it is 31st December. Okay, so what I mentioned here, I think first is a month, then year, day and then year. So 31st December, 31st 1999. I can apply filtering this way and it will filter out those records, okay, which are after the given date. So it has filtered out all the records which are after 31st December 1999. All the records it has filtered. So I can apply filtering this way. Let me apply filtering on the cells also. And here I can apply filtering. Filtering after. Same. Basic 31st 12/31st 1999. Clicking on OK. OK. So variety of transformations are available. OK, you can explore it further to know what are all different transformations you can apply. But variety of transformations you can apply. I want to add a new column there. I want to split the columns of product. So here is a product. And here is a product which is mentioning the company name and the model. I want to separate. Or I want to add a hyphen between them. As a space is there, I want to add a hyphen between them. So for that purpose, let me check for it. Let me select for product. Home. Date, first of all. No, this column only I want to split. Just a minute. I want to introduce a new column there. Add column, custom column, here I can choose for it. And here it is asking me the column name. So I may be giving a name to this column as cust column cust 01. I will do some modifications and the final column, I will give appropriate name to the final column, and the intermediate column I am giving some temporary name because these columns I will be dropping a little bit later. Now from here, which column we want to get? So product. So here I am getting a product column. So I am first of all creating a duplicate column of it so that I can apply different operations over there without doing modifications into existing column. And here you will observe it has created a duplicate column. Now on this column, I want to again apply some customization. So right clicking again. Split column, I want to split it. As I know, there is a delimiter, a space delimiter between these two, company name and model name. So I am choosing for the delimiter. Delimiter will be space, and I wanted to search for that delimiter from the left. See, without writing any code, I am able to do it. Without writing any code, I am able to do it. That is something really nice. Just a minute. Yes, see, it has splitted the columns with a space. It has splitted the column. I want to add a new column. OK, where I will combine these two columns. to create a third column having the values from both these columns, but there will be hyphen between. So I am creating a new custom column. Custom column, I may name it as a, you know, say brand and model. Brand hyphen model is the name I am giving to it. Brand hyphen model. Yes. And here what things I have to take is the cust column one. Then I want to add a plus sign between, sorry, a hyphen sign between. Again, I'm appending plus sign or append. Append is available in Excel sheet. Oh, sorry, ampersand. Yes. Fine.
So, sorry to interrupt you. Basically, the splitting the columns and this whatever you are doing now, adding both the columns and modifying it. So these things we can do it easily in Excel as well. We can do this using concatenate function in the Excel. Splitting is also very easy. Easily we can do it in Excel. So what exactly is different in Power BI?
I am coming to it. The very first point I want to bring to your notice is, for visualization, Power BI is known for visualization.
Okay.
In Power BI, for visualization, Power BI itself has a feature to process the data, to clean the data, to transform the data. I don't have to go to Excel for doing those things.
Okay.
I can go into Excel and do those things there also. But what if I don't know Excel? Why should I learn Excel separately and Power BI separately? I can try these things in Power BI itself. That is one thing. But if I know Excel, still in the same way, I can do the things in Power BI without much differences.
Okay.
If I know Excel, I can learn Power BI rather quickly.
Okay. Thank you.
Fine. So it has been created. Finally, what I will have to do is whatever changes I want to apply on the data, I will apply. Okay, and then I will load that data for creating different visuals. So for that purpose, close and apply. So I will close and apply it. So close and apply both. So this editor, I want to close and I want to apply this data, okay, into Power BI. Visualization. So for that purpose, here I am clicking on close and apply. And now it will be taking some time, you know, because whatever changes we have made onto the data, all those changes it has to apply. Okay, that is one thing. And second thing is, it has to make whole data ready for further analysis. So now it is loading that data and it is applying all the changes. So one more point I would like to bring to your notice is that whenever I am applying the different steps, you might have noticed that in the right side, it is mentioning those steps in the order in which I am running those steps. So original data is untouched. It is recording the steps. Okay, but it is showing me snippet of the code which I get after applying those steps. So original data plus steps to be applied was being shown to me, and now actual steps it is applying on the data and it is creating a kind of a data set. How many rows it is applying all these steps, that is also being shown. So some of the tables here are very large. Fact tables specifically are very large. You can see sales is a fact table and product may be a dimension table. Okay, and that is what it has done now. Okay, and here to the right side, you can see that table names it had changed because I, you know, gave it some of the stuff to change the table names. Okay, if you can see sales table. No, not sales table, which is a product table. Okay, in the product table, we applied brand, we applied some column specific operations, and it is showing me filtered data as well as, you know, modified data. So this is a modified data, what it is showing to me. On this data now, we will apply different visuals. So for that purpose, okay, see, normally we take one break after 1 hour. So is it good? We should take a 2-3 minutes break. It's almost more than an hour. So shall we take 2-3 minutes break?
Yes.
Yeah, fine.
Yes.
So it is 11:21. We will resume our session within 3-4 minutes at the most, by 11:25.
Okay.
Fine.
Okay.
Sir, one small doubt, sir.
Yeah.
So now we have you have created custom column, right? So yeah. Along with, we have already geo options like split columns and merge column option is there, right? You can, yes, directly use that one, right? What is the special purpose of using custom column?
Got your question. Normally what we do is we do not alter the changes into existing table or existing data. We may create a new column, we may apply different changes, okay, and we retain older values as they are. That's why I created a new column. Otherwise, yeah, I would have
also, we have option, right, sir, in transform tab options. If we use the existing columns, will get disturbed, but when we go for add column related option, means it will create, it will not touch the existing column, and it will create new column, and it will perform the operation whatever we want without disturbing the existing column, right? So
yes, correct. So,
special purpose for going only custom column option.
Yes, sir. So, same column, if you want to change, you can apply transformation, but that is not recommended.
What I need to say is, in the Power Query Editor, we have the option like, we have the option, right, merge columns and split columns. So we can use those options, right, instead of going by custom column, means we have to write M language code and all, right? So GUI option also, we can achieve this requirement.
Yes. I just added a step. I created a duplicate column. To show you how can we create a duplicate column, and then I applied everything, every kind of transformation on the duplicate column. Okay. Just give me a minute, I will be back in a minute. So let me come back, and here, first of all, as we have made the data ready, so here, first of all, from that data, I will draw some visuals. So maybe first of all, let us draw a pie chart. So I'm clicking on the pie chart, and I have to set some parametric values here. So sales data, and from the sales data, let me check for units. And there is a location data from where I will check for region. So here I am checking region into regions, and units I am dragging into values. And here is a graph it is showing to me. In this graph, if you want to do some cosmetic changes, you can do those changes from here. So maybe some legends if you want to drop, or you want to change the colors, not from here, from here only you can change the colors. Okay, so legend colors, for example. Okay, so different types of, you know, cosmetic changes you can do from here. Okay, but this way we can draw a pie chart. Okay, such different types of visuals are available. If I want to draw say tree map, just a minute, Z. Tree map, I have clicked on the canvas and I just draw a tree map. So I can, you know, drag the tree map and show it, place it wherever I want. If I want to, you know, mention the columns on which it should show me the tree map. Okay, what is the significance of pie chart? In what case do we need a pie chart to be used? So pie chart is a circular, and it shows me total or maximum value as 100% or 360 degree. And there it is showing me that out of this 360 degree, okay, this this region is a west region. This region is a east region. So different regions it is showing to me. So out of 360 degree, how much is the share of every region that is being shown through the pie chart? Okay, this is a tree map which shows me nested rectangles also. It can show me nested rectangles, and it also can show me, you know, out of this whole area, how much is a part or area, a specific type of, you know, data is consuming. So after all, they are showing me different kinds of aggregations. Okay, so here I choose for manufacturer. Just a minute. So here is the manufacturer. Okay, I am checking for the manufacturer and the product. I want to know which manufacturer. I go into the product first. And here I choose for manufacturer. And then from cells, I go to unit. So cell product wise or cell manufacturer wise is being shown. And here I can realize that this Natura vendor has a maximum sell in our outlets. Okay, so such type of different graphs can be drawn. So next can be bar and line chart. Okay, so let me just draw a bar and line chart. So here it is. I am choosing the complex one, which will show me line and stacked column chart also. So here I am choosing it. Just a minute. I have to click here and then I am clicking here. Yes, I just arrange it here. Okay, now let us select date, year in the date to know year wise. Here it is. In the shared axis, I am moving date, not date actually, year. Let me move year wise if I want to see. In the shared axis, let me drag it here. Okay, in the column values, let me draw unit. Here, let me drop from here. Okay, and then for x-axis, sales, revenue, let me draw it in line value, charges, let me draw in line value. Revenue, let me draw here column values, and units, let me draw in line values. And here is the graph it is showing to you. If I want a different color for it, I can set the color from here. Okay, so x-axis linear legend. From where I can choose the color for those vertical bars. Left linear. I do have not here, just a minute. Data color, default color. Let me select this one. Fine. So you can play with it and you can accordingly design different types of visuals by setting different types of colors to it. Fine. So such type of different visuals we can draw here, and I have got the data here, I have got different types of visuals here. At last I want to publish this thing, so I want to share all this thing to create the dashboard.
Can I have one question, please? Here.
Yes.
Can we compare with a weekly revenue data here? Maybe comparison between previous week and preceding previous week. Is it possible?
It is possible. Obviously, it is possible. The only thing is, I will have to have data in that way. But it is possible. I will have to separate this date. This date does have year, month, day. I will have to separate the day from the rest of the date. And then accordingly, I can create a filtering also. So two different visuals I can create, one for last week and another for this week. Okay, so in order to draw the visuals for last week, I simply have to filter all remaining records and I have to have only the records of the last week. So those steps we will have to follow, but yes, it is possible.
Okay. So, is it possible to show how to split this in a week wise? Is it possible to show it in this session?
No. Just don't ask me because I am already running out of paucity of the time. I am running out of time. So, but yes, it is possible, and we splitted the brand and product in our earlier exercise, right?
Yeah.
On the same line, I can split all the three sub parameters of the date. That is possible. Similar type of splitting option is available there. Yes. After this, what I do is I have to click on publish. I'm clicking on publish, and here it is asking me, do you want to save your changes? Yes, I am saving the changes, clicking on save. Okay, in case if I want to save it with some name, say maybe SSDB modified. Okay, if I want to save, I will save it on the disk on my local machine. Okay, and now here on the service, it is asking me, where should it publish? Now this is Power BI service. This is not in my machine. This is on the cloud. Okay, so Chandra WS, clicking on select. And now it is publishing it on the cloud. Let me take you to the cloud.
So one more question. Can you just go back to that page? Previous. So here we have relational view also, right? Left side, left icon.
Left icon. You mean these are? Yes.
Yeah, down one relational. So when do we use that in actual?
For example, see, I have got a set of tables from one data source, and another set of table from another data source. Just to explain through some real life example, I got fact table from one data source and dimension tables from another data source. So then I have to, you know, establish a joins between these two. So there, then I will go with that.
Okay. So at that point, we need this relational schemes and all to be done, right? And we don't need SQL statements also there?
No, no. It is a graphical tool. You simply have to drag and drop the relations between two tables. Okay. Graphical tool. And not only from different data sources, even if we are getting a data from one data source and there we want to establish relationship in between two tables, then I can use that graphical tool and I can establish a relationship between those two tables, okay, between the foreign key column of one table with a, another column of the another table.
Okay.
Yeah,
thank you.
Yes. Okay, fine. So it has been published. So I am going to the portal. My workspace. Just a minute, let me refresh it. Workspaces. Here is the Chandra workspace. This is browser-based tool now. This is a browser-based tool. Okay, and here you observe AccessDB modified data. A data set has been created here. Okay, and here I can see the visuals that have been created. So if I click here, okay, I can create a report from scratch from here, or if I want to see the reports, so here you can see I can create a new dashboard, I can create the report. So here is the reports visuals what we have created. Okay, now here I can change their sizes. I can even take them to the dashboard. Okay, so here, this report I want to be added into the dashboard. So I have to pin it to the dashboard. So I'm clicking here. Here it is asking me, should I create a new dashboard or go with the existing dashboard? So here I want to create a new dashboard, maybe some dashboard I want to create, Chandra dashboard. Clicking on pin. So it has created a dashboard, and to that dashboard, you know, it has added that visual. Same, this visual also, or this visual also, I want to pin to the same dashboard. So I will click on pinning. Existing dashboard, Chandra dashboard, and I will pin it. So, create mobile layout, that is different thing, huh? Okay, go to dashboard. In this dashboard, I can see two different visuals. I can see two different visuals, and hereby we have created a dashboard. Hereby we have created the dashboard.
Okay, so we want multiple tabs, and we cannot have in a dashboard, right?
Multiple tabs means? What do you mean by multiple tabs?
So if we want multiple tabs, say like there are 40 visuals, we want maybe 20 visuals on one page, 20 on some other page, then we cannot have a dashboard for it, right? So then it will have to be a report only.
But here we can add multiple pages also. Just a minute. I have got the data set here. This is a data set what I have got. Okay, I am creating a report. And here I can create a multiple pages also of the report. And here also.
Yeah, so we can create, but in a dashboard, I think there is only one page that is supported, right? In the dashboard from where you pinned the visuals from report to the dashboard, right? So in the dashboard, I think I could see only one page.
Yes, that one page is scrollable. That one page is scrollable. So on the dashboard, it has to be, you know, accommodated in one screen. That's why it doesn't have page wise. But in the report, I can have it a page wise, so multiple pages also I can add here in the report.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, any changes to this data? So these dashboards are refreshed automatically, or they need some intervention?
There are two types of reports we can generate. One report is where we have to publish the data. Then only the changes are reflected. And another report is real-time data. In case of real-time data, you know, changes are automatically reflected. But in case of static data, we have to publish that. We have to publish data set. Hello?
How can you make use of this, you know, filters and slicers in the dashboard page, the one which you created, Chandra dashboard, right? So where is it possible to make use of the slicer and filters in the same page?
We call them as interactive visuals. So we can create interactive visuals also, and there we can add filters or what we call it, the drop downs in every visual. So such visuals are called as interactive.
I'm asking within the dashboard. Can you go back to that in a Chandra dashboard which you created just now? So
just a minute.
Yeah, below is there.
Why it is not showing me? Just a minute.
Within the reports.
No, just a minute. I will have to change the workspace.
Can you add any filters in this dashboard?
We can add filters. I will have to convert it into interactive dashboard. We can add filters here. As of now, I have static static. What we will say? All these are the static visuals. I will have to add a filter here. I will have to convert it into interactive, and then I will have to add the filter here.
How we need to convert this as interactive?
Yes, all these points we can cover separately. As of now,
or at least minimum, can cover. You show, like, you know, because in the report, please add one filter, and can you pin that filter to this dashboard? Is it possible? Because I don't think so. Can you try and can you show?
You do one thing. You mention your query in the form and share. I will share you the steps. Please do that.
Okay.
Okay, fine. So a part of it I just have explained to you. It is
Sir, I have a question. Suppose I need to share this report with someone who doesn't have Power BI installed on their machine. So how, like, can I?
We can add users here. Into Power BI, we can declare the users, and thereby we can decide to which user what kind of report privilege to be given.
Through web, it can be shared.
Yes.
Okay.
I am extremely sorry for not accepting the questions hereafter, because there is one more agenda I have to complete. Let me just quickly complete it, and then we will get some 5-10 minutes therein, and I will accept your questions. Okay, so this is regarding, in case if you want to go with examination of a DA-100, how is the examination pattern? How can you appear for the examination? So let me just quickly elaborate to you and make you comfortable for going for the examination. Actually, this subject is becoming very hot day by day because of, heavy demand. And here we are, because of this pandemic, this leap is you know, delayed, but we do expect a great leap all over the world. You know, all giant companies are expecting a great leap in using data analytics in the business, and they do definitely are, you know, needing lots of skilled guys. So I do see maybe within 1 or 2 years, it has been delayed by just a few years. I do see within a couple of years, okay, and other different companies who are showing us statistics every month, they are also expecting lots of placements to happen in coming 1 or 2 years. So that leap is awaited. As far as data analytics is concerned, developers also can come to this field. It is really easy for them to come to this field because, you know, in case if they are Java developer, going for the Python is not at all a big deal for them. It is just a concept same and change in the, you know, semantics and syntax only. Python is very simple to learn and its learning curve is far less, far small compared to Java. If you are from database background, again, most of the tools available here are drag and drop and UI based tool. Okay, and you don't have to write a long language codes, you know, for working on it. So even if you are coming from database background, you know, not much difficult for you to jump start here, because many tools, even in machine learning also, you know, you don't have to write a Python code. Okay, there are tools, drag and drop like tools in Azure ML Designer, you know, where you simply can, without writing a code, you can do machine learning modeling. If you are from testing background, again, you do have some insight of coding, okay, but you can use the tools which are graphic based, and you can even do a small kind of coding also for doing a small kind of small kind of customizations while using these tools. So what is happening is that now all these different companies are moving towards codeless experience. So you don't have to write a code, but get everything done. So even if you are from a testing background, not to worry about all these tools are, you will be able to, you know, practice more on all these things. Whenever you are doing a certification, it adds a great value to your profile. Okay, and your profile become the part of the search, okay, LinkedIn search. So it benefits to you on your professional front. It is always a proud moment for you. Okay, even your companies also, and different companies who are, you know, looking for you for working on different projects, you know, they also prefer if you are certified. So I did not have to mention much benefits of certification. All of you are aware. Okay, but definitely these certifications are really valuable. Microsoft certifications are really valuable. Azure certifications are extremely valuable in the market as on today. If you try to go for DA100 certification, you know, these are 5 modules and their weightages are also mentioned. So preparing the data, I explained you how you can prepare the data. You also did ask me the question, how can we split the data? What are all different transformations we can apply? How do we create the model of the data? How do we create the joins between the tables? Everything, you know, visualization, how we create a visualization of the data. Okay, in analyzing, how do we query the data? Some way we could not visit that part today, okay? But how can we query the data? How can we deploy and deploy our models? And how can we make the models and our reports, charts, accessible into web applications, accessible on the dashboard. Okay, so overall curriculum has been divided into these 5 models, and this is the weightage. And here you can see first 3 models are having a weightage. If I count minimum weightage also, okay, first 3 models are counting for 75% of the weightage. So that point to be noted. Your examination will be of around 210 minutes. Actual examination out of 210 minutes will be of 180 minutes. There is no practical examination. there will be MCQ examination only. In 180 minutes, there will be around 45 to 55 different questions asked to you. These are single choice questions or multi-choice questions. There may be some questions where small case study you will be given with. Okay, and based on that case study, there will be around 5 questions. So all those 5 questions will form a part of questions out of 55. Okay, now those 5 questions are navigable. Means you can move from question 1 to question 2, and from question 2 you can come back to question 1. Those 5 questions are navigable. But if you go to next case study, small case study, which has next set of 5 questions, once you move to next case study, then you cannot come back to the earlier case study to answer the questions. So case study based questions will be given to you at the beginning. Whenever you are beginning with the examination, initially you will see case study based questions, and these questions will be around 20 to 25. Okay, and then individual questions will be there. Those individual questions will be remaining, so those will be around say 30 questions. Individual questions are easy to answer. These case study based questions, you may find, actually, you know, you may find some of the questions difficult to answer, but if you carefully read that question, you will realize this question is really easy to answer. They narrate very long story, but you will see there are one or two relevant questions only from where you can give the answer quickly, but they narrate whole story. So don't look at the size of the question. Look at the actual sentences where you will have to get the answer to the question. No negative marking, that is very important point. So just do not leave even a single question unattended. You can appear for the examination even from the home. I am appearing for the examination from the home since 2 years. I have stopped going to the proctored center, okay, and appearing for the examination only from the home. Okay, this is the format I already have explained to you, and I mentioned about small case study and individual questions. Just few hints to appear for the examination. Carefully go through MOC material, how you will prepare for the examination. So MOC material for the examination is available on the net. You can go through it and you can prepare for it. Don't limit yourself to that material. One thing is pretty sure, that 50% of questions, 60 to 70% of questions will come from the material, but there will be 30% questions which will come from little bit out of the material. Why I say little bit? Okay, not very difficult questions will come into the examination, but from the material, if you further more explore the subject, you will be in position to answer most of the questions. Questions are not memory based. Questions are logic based. So after you read the question, you apply the logic and then choose the answer for the question. Don't leave any question unanswered. Okay, so quickly go through these points. Sometimes questions are very long, but answer, while finding the answer, only 2-3 statements are relevant. Sometimes questions are twisted. Okay, but answer is very simple. So it may give you the sense, examination questions may give you the sense that examination is a little bit tough. Okay, but believe me, there are very, very few questions which are really tough. Otherwise, most of the questions are very simple to answer. This doesn't mean that you should be short of your preparation. You will have to do the preparation of the study material. Okay. Appearing for different certification courses and then going for the examination is very normal trained. So here we go for the examination after we appear for the certification courses. We do run different certification courses. So we have persona based onboarding. I am just fast forwarding some of the slides because you know that these slides have been covered into beginning introduction, so I am just fast forwarding. Microsoft Online Examination, Pearson VUE carry this examination here in India. Okay, and you can visit, you can do a Google search for DA100 Azure certification. You will land up on this page. From here, you can, you know, schedule the examination. You can decide whenever. Nowadays, what is happening is that these examinations are available. You can choose a slot 24/7. Any slot you can choose, because these are on online examinations. We don't have to, you know, schedule the examination as per the availability of the proctor center. Okay, online examinations, you can give examination even in the midnight also. So if you feel your mind is fresh in the midnight, okay, you can go for these examinations in the midnight also. System requirements, your normal laptop works. The only thing is your laptop, you should connect directly, keep yourself out of firewall of the company. Okay, so you can start this examination from incognito window. Okay, what you have to do is, once you schedule the examination, Pearson VUE run one browser based software in your machine, which validates all hardware of your machine that is needed to monitor the examination. Somebody else will keep monitoring the examination. Don't be in impression that in case if you are appearing for the examination, nobody will monitor. No, somebody will keep monitoring you. Okay, so your video will be on all the time, your audio will be on all the time, and whenever you are appearing for the examination, there must not be anybody around you, there must not be any laptop around you. Okay, you must not be doing your lips movements. You must not be looking into mobile. You must not be looking here or there. Very strict decoration you have to maintain. Okay, so but otherwise your normal laptop with a appropriate video, appropriate internet, and appropriate audio. These three things are important. Okay, and thereby you can appear for the examination. That's all from my side. I would like to, you know, hear anything from you. Okay, I don't have much time to answer your queries. I will request you to mention your queries in your form, okay, and submit them. We will try to revert back to you. That's all from my side.
Yep, thank you. Thanks a lot. Good session.
Yes,
thank you so much. Yes, sir. Rupesh here.
Rupesh.
I'll take care from here.
Yes.
So thank you so much, sir, for a wonderful session. Even on the last minute change, you have delivered a great session, and I hope everyone understood the concept of this. I request everyone to just be here for 5 minutes. I'll be real quick. There are a few announcements I want to remind quickly. So I'll be sharing my screen. Just a moment, please. I hope my screen is visible to all. I don't take.
Yes,
as I said already, this. Yeah. So this is a web training calendar for the month. So anyone is interested, they can get back to me. The number is already shared in the chat box. As I've said, currently we are offering 50% flat off on all the trainings. Our next certification webinar is on PL100. Introduction to Power Virtual Agent, that is happening on 24th of July. The session will be in the morning for 2 hours, 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. So whoever is interested, they can register themselves. We have already shared the link. This is a yearly webinar session calendar for your reference. I know it's a long list. But yeah, one by one, in every session, we are going to announce the next session. So as I've already told you about this Cert Ready webinar. So along with that, we are also running one special webinar series that is based on emerging technologies. So our next emerging technology webinar will be on 10th of July, and the topic is DevSecOps. So whoever is interested, they can register themselves. As I've told already, the next we are going to select 5 lucky winners from the feedback forms which will be submitted from you. I've already shared the feedback form link in the chat box. So those will be selected randomly. So do share your valuable feedbacks to us. Last but not the least, one special campaign announcement that is conducted by Microsoft. So I hope that you all are active on LinkedIn. You all have your active account on LinkedIn. So I'll request everyone. So once as you have attended today's webinar, or if you have given any certification exam recently and you have got your badge, so do update that. There are 2 different sections available on your LinkedIn profile. One is skills and endorsement. Another is license and certification. So if you have got any certification recently, so do update that under the license and certification. And you can update your skills under skills and endorsement. So with that thing, you just have to enroll yourself for the campaign, as I've said. So this campaign, under this campaign, one lucky winner could win a Microsoft Surface Go laptop every month. Okay. So to register for this campaign, you have to follow a link. That link is given in the feedback form at the last session. You can check that link. Here are a few steps that you need to follow to get your badge. You can follow our YouTube social media channels, LinkedIn, YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and you will be notified with the latest announcements from Synergetics. If you want the session recording, that will be uploaded on YouTube channel. Please do subscribe that. We have already shared the channel link. So thank you so much for attending the webinar. Hope to see you in the next session. Have a great weekend, everyone. Thanks a lot. And also, if you have any question, do mention that in the comment section that is given in the feedback form. Okay. So we'll try to resolve all the questions or queries that you have mentioned in the feedback forms. Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.